for the first time, three UW-Whitewater science students in wheelchairs traveled to Yellowstone National Park for a two-week field study program.
Coming this far from home to a whole new environment, a whole new everything, is very scary.
Probably my number one concern was just like day-to-day living, like making sure I'm taken care of and...
No, I wasn't concerned at all. I was really excited. Had the countdown going on the laptop. I was just super stoked.
Look at him! He's checking out his visitors!
Just doing a little jig down the middle of the road, no biggie.
And it's sort of a muddy cauldron or a muddy hot spring.
Any questions? What do you think? Do you think that's Absarca volcanics or do you think that's sedimentary rock?
Or think volcanics.
Well, it is.
We drive so that the students get to see the change in climate. They're not flying out here, they're not tourists. You know, it's a field course that shows them the basics of field work in a lot of different areas. It's sort of a smorgasbord.
This is a pine because it's got clump needles.
We do vegetation analysis. You know, they're doing things and they're out there in the field, but this is the kind of stuff that you can learn because you're seeing it.
Being in a classroom and reading a textbook, you get the information, but you don't get to be able to learn it while you're looking at it. You don't just memorize the name of a tree and what its characteristics are. You see it, you feel it.
Part of the vegetation analysis is that we do tree coring. All the trees are about 85 years old.
It's been awesome working with George. He's a good teacher. He works really hard to make sure we can all participate in at least some aspects of it.
Basically, I'm the teaching assistant, so all the behind the scenes work, I help out with George, get everything prepared for the night before. Then for me, I had to load them all in, you know, do little clips on the floor every time we made a stop. They're very impressive, and what they have to go through on a daily basis and how positive outlook they put on it, it's really cool.
Not only do they learn techniques, but they learn confidence. They learn that they can fix something out in the field. We're setting up a trapping grid, so they have to use compass, they have to use GPS, they have to use, you know, mathematics, which is interesting sometimes.
I call that going into the trees.
Oh, it's not that far in.
We set up a series of animal traps. All right, you throw it in the bottom of it.
Go left.
Is that it then?
My job is to teach students, and they're just another group of students as far as I'm concerned. These three women that are there, I think they're an inspiration to everyone that they've met. And I didn't know anything about this. I didn't know that the doorways have to be so wide to get wheelchairs through, or I didn't know you have to have certain things to do all this, you know. And the Center for Students with Disabilities, those are the ones that said, well, you're gonna need this, you're gonna need that, and this and that, the other thing. I had a little bit of training about a few things, but all in all, they were the ones that put it together. And, you know, without them, this wouldn't have happened.
It's good for me to see the students out there and just to see what some of their issues and concerns are even. We're making a boardwalk that's accessible to all visitors, and we're going to remove all of the old boardwalk and stairs that are currently in place there in the Norris Geyser Basin.
It's the geyser, it's like the volcano, just everything I ever thought it would be. It was really cool. I didn't know there were so many in a row. I loved it.
It'll go higher.
Yeah!
It'll go higher yet. Wow!
It is just beautiful.
We don't have privileged kids there. We have, you know, salt of the earth kids. And maybe they've never seen this. So this is a good chance to show them it. They're the kind of students that are going to push me to make them do the most that they can do.
And we have Lauren helping and George and I. Maybe Cal. We could have him helping too.
I thought they were insane, but they were like, we're gonna go down this hill. I was like, that's a cliff, George.
I was like, yeah, right, okay. Oh, okay, sure, we'll go down there, all right.
Like, I'm pretty brave, but even that looks like a cliff, basically. So I had to like give all my trust to George and trusting him that he would lead me down the right path.
Wow!
It took like a lot of the bumps out. I mean, I was still bouncing every which way, but it wasn't nearly as bad as it probably would have been.
We had one mat, drive on, move it, go to the front, drive on, go to the front, on and on and on, until we got to hard enough ground for my wheels to drive on.
Terrifying, but exhilarating.
Damn few people ever seen a wolf, and fewer yet have tracked a wolf. And right where you are, there was a wolf.
And then we actually found the tracks of the wolf, and then it was all worth it after that, putting the plaster in and getting the mold.
Oh, this is so awesome.
Oh, look what's coming out.
It was really cool to see once you cleaned it off, the paw print, and it was like a piece of history that you always have.
The feeling, it overwhelmed me for a while. I teared up a little, just the fact that I had accomplished something to that extent.
I didn't think that was possible, but it happened, so no, I think we could pretty much do anything now.
I think this trip really pushed my limits and showed how many things I can actually do.
They enjoyed it so much, they all want to come back next year.
If there's a way to make a place accessible, you should do it.
Yeah.
Because they're no different than a walking person. They want to see the same things, and it should be normal to see three wheelchairs drive through Yellowstone.